Hello, I'm Linda Cromar. I'm coming to you from my home office in Colorado, and I wanted to share with you some good insights on how you can be a lot more organized in your business. In fact, I have 5 good points that you can put into action immediately. So stay tuned. I'm going to give them all to you right here and right now. So let me actually put on my glasses so I can see what I'm reading, because I made notes to make sure that I'm giving you efficient and good time. So you're not going to miss anything of importance, because I'm not going to spend any time doing rada, 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 rada. And thanks for all of the people that are part of this, watching it now, and thanks for all the people on the replay. Anyway, so let's go right on to it. 1, before you start doing any live videos like I'm doing today, I went through my space and made sure that it was clean and orderly. So I decided to check my space because I wanted to make sure that the video was not going to show a bunch of trash or clutter. Now, that doesn't mean there isn't any at all, because I'm not that good at cleaning up, but I try to make sure my videos have a good workspace, whether I'm inside or outside. I always take kind of a quick look at my whole surrounding area to make sure that it looks as good as it can. And then as much as possible, clean up. That's 2, clean up. Clean your space, clean your house. Now, that doesn't mean that your whole day is spent that way. If you get organized, you don't have to make your cleaning your house be an all-day experience. For instance, I'm doing laundry, but I'm not making it be my whole day. I'm not letting it take away from what needs to happen as far as doing my business activities every day. I'm making sure I do my laundry. I'm making sure I do my dishes. I'm making sure I cook. But those things don't take away from my business time. I plan and organize my day. So 3, eliminate clutter. Now, you can do this both digitally and you can do it also in your house. Now, I had to make a great big change in my house with moving my office upstairs to what is actually considered the master bedroom. This is really not set necessarily as a good place to have an office, but I've had to do a lot of adjusting and cleaning and cluttering, uncluttering to make this work. For some reason, a smaller room about half the size had more clutter and more stuff in it than this room does now. And that's because as I moved upstairs, I uncluttered a lot of things I didn't need. And one thing you also do is you look through gadgets and electronics and you say, am I really using this? Is it still important to me? Is it important to my business or my personal life? And then make it go to the right place considering that. Like, for instance, I don't have a lot of personal stuff upstairs. I do have my clothes because I don't have closet space downstairs. But other than that, I don't have a lot of my personal stuff upstairs. That way, this becomes just my office. And when I turn off the lights at night, I turn off the phone, I turn off Facebook, I turn off LinkedIn, and whatever else I'm doing. I don't look at my emails or my Facebook during the evening. I spend that time with my husband. So that's 3. 4, have a written plan, but keep it simple. Okay, I'm going to say have 5 to 6 things that you're going to do daily, but keep it to about that amount, because if you try to have a list that's too long, there's going to be a lot of problem with trying to accomplish that, because your life will probably get in the way. And make it so that you simply can accomplish it. Make it something you want to do, make it something you need to do, and you realize those steps are necessary for your business to accomplish any kind of real goals. For instance, there's things we do on Facebook we don't have to do. We don't have to scroll the timeline every 5 minutes. We really don't. And we don't need to comment on absolutely every post that we see. But we do need to have a plan that actually will help us create leads and sales. That's your real plan. How many actions do you need to take to create leads and sales? Really, there aren't a whole lot of other things you have to do besides that. And then number five, of course, actually carry out that plan. If you made it simple enough, then you know what you need to do every day. One thing that's important, you know, I have a son that is handicapped. He's in his 40s and he lives on his own. But he has a job at a janitorial service where he actually goes to a military base and he cleans up a daycare center. Now, there are set things that he has to do daily, like empty the trash, wipe down all the surfaces, and various different things like that. Probably run the vacuum cleaner. And those kinds of things are daily activities that he has to do as his part of his job. Well, the same thing happens for us. We have daily activities that are necessary to build our business. Unfortunately, there's some that really are not actually daily activities that build your business, like a whole bunch of posts on Facebook don't guarantee that you're going to build your business. If you have a strategic post you must do daily, like a live, for instance, if it's done right, then that can be a business activity. If it creates leads, if it creates conversation, if it creates the opportunity to share your business in the right way without spamming, then it is a business activity. Here's one that isn't. A lot of you will not like this one, but just sharing your link without permission, in other words, all over Facebook, is not necessarily a business activity because it does not necessarily create any leads or sales. Now, what will is if you have a conversation with someone and then you get to the point where you're ready to say, yes, I can offer you more information. Here's a link to help you get the more information you're asking for. When you're doing it that way, that's acceptable. But you have to know the difference. Just throwing your link out on Facebook is basically spam. And nobody is actually interested in seeing your link unless they find a reason to say, yes, that's valuable to me. Please give me your link. So first you have to start a conversation and talk to people. You know what? At the end of the day, it's still about talking to people because people are the ones that are going to buy. And they only buy if they find it of value to them. If you want to learn more about how I can help you market your company in a different way that is a lot more valuable and a lot less spam, then you need to be talking to me. And that's what I have to share with you today. I hope you found that awesome. And if you did, please like, comment, and share. And I'll be seeing you again tomorrow. Bye for now.